first wig installation using luxurious hair. This is my first time buying from this vendor, so hopefully the results are good. So far, so good. The packaging was good. It didn't smell too bad, even when it was packaged coming from the storage. And usually it smells really bad, some hairs. Honey, don't clock me for this wig right here, because this is just a little throw on before I do what I do. So usually I just throw my little wigs because it's really simple wigs that don't really come with too much. But I wanted to do the cat method for the first time, and I decided to do it today. It came with like a wig cap, which I don't think I'm going to use because it's black. And no, I don't think I'm going to use that. Alright, this is how it looks. It's really curly. I'm going to do a hair review talking about it all after this video. It comes with a really thin lace, so I think it'll be an easy installment. This is what I washed and conditioned it with, but it is a limited edition Iceberry Queen shampoo and conditioner. And it smells so freaking good. Like, I would not lie to you. This smells so good. All right, you guys, so I'm just gonna go ahead and throw the wig on, style it, do my makeup, and we'll see how things go. Stay right here. Don't go nowhere. I'll be right back. Guys, so I just did my wig installment, and the edges are kind of extra right now, but I really don't know how to do my edges, so I just do the best I can.
I don't know whether to
slip
it like that way or slip it like this.
I don't know what to say about it. Took me an hour, which is kind of sad, but I don't know how you guys be doing your edges so quick and so simple. Alright, so I'm gonna start with my makeup. I may be looking over here because my mirror is right here, my camera's right here. All my makeup is on that side. So I don't really want to say what kind of look we're going for because it will be totally opposite.
I'm just gonna go and let my hands do the work. The look we have, we have.
Alright, first I'm gonna start with this cream sorbet. It's nothing special. This is just something I'm using for today. This is just some moisturizer, cream sorbet, whatever. I'm just going in with the NARS product foundation that I got from Sephora. It sucks that I can't do like the whole tutorial thing and I have to go like kind of quick because my storage is not open like that. So this is my color in NARS. Guys, so I just kind of went in with the NARS foundation and the Fit Me foundation, the powder one. So now I do want to say it's time for the eyeshadow, which is kind of complicated, but I'll do my best. The eyeshadow I love to do because you can like express yourself with eyeshadow and do all type of fun stuff, but I really don't know what color I'm going to use today. I do want to use like some eyeshadows and stuff that I got from the pop-up shop. I will be showing you guys what I got from there.
So this is all the stuff that I got from the pop-up shop. This is the Evolution brush set. I opened it a little bit so I can feel how soft it was, and it was pretty soft. I like it. And then this is, I guess, a little bit here, a little home. And then this is the highlighters. This is the cute eye hatcher. Like, I hatcher. And then this is the highlighter. This is the cute eye hatcher. Like, I hatcher. It was so pretty. And of course, I swatched it before I bought it. And then this is the Olivia set. I don't know how that got there. But Olivia palette. That's really cute. Maybe I can get it. And these are like that way. Like, I never seen them before, but I definitely swatched this one yesterday. And literally, a dot was like so amazing. I'll show you guys. And then, last but not least, this one color. And this was only $35. This one I believe was like $18. This was $20 or $30 something. And this was about $8. And these were only $3.
It's really cool and cheap. This is not an ad, this is not a sponsor, anything like that. It's just the stuff that I got from the pop-up shop. It's Mica Beauty Cosmetics. This one is a gold, and then this one is a shimmery white. It's really cool and pigmented. I really like it. I'm gonna swatch it for you.
It comes like this. I'm just gonna swatch it really quick using this little brush. So it's a really nice golden color. It literally gets everywhere, so you have to be really careful with it. Alright, so now I'm gonna use the white eyeshadow. Alright, we want to get that focus. See, this is that's the gold and that's the white. It's really shimmery and pigmented. So cute.
Alright, so those are really fun to play with. And then the second thing I got is the Olivia Beauty Creations Olivia palette. And this is really cute. I feel like I had to get it because it had like such a nice like color to it. So I felt like I had to get it, and it had like different colors that I feel like I didn't have enough of, like warm colors. It has nice little warm colors, and I love my golds. I love golds. This is still from Beauty Creations. It's a highlighter palette. Alright you guys, so I had to get this palette because it was so cute and I fell in love with it. It has the palm trees and everything, and you know we in Florida, so I had to cop it. And it was really sparkly. I love how it looks on my cheekbone. I also used that one about twice already, so it was a good purchase. All of it together was just like $130, which is really good for all the stuff that I got. And I thought it would be way more, but you know, your girl know how to budget and get what she want, what she needed in the right way, in the right price.
Bitch, what the fuck? What the fuck?
But you know, your girl know how to budget, so. I did not get this from the pop-up shop. I got it from Aventura Mall in Miami. It is the Jaclyn Hill palette. It was like $38. It wasn't too bad. And I had the money, so I was like, why not spoil myself, pamper myself a little bit. But honestly, I bought this palette because it was either Bretman highlighters or this palette. And I got this palette because of this color here. So the Pool Party, Jada, Royalty, and Torque is the reason I got this palette. Because I never really see this color in any palettes. So I kind of had it for a couple months and I've been using it. And I love my gold, so of course the main ones I'm gonna use is like right here, over here. Over here is Queen, and that's the gold one, so you know that's me.
I don't know what color I'm going to use yet, but I'm going to go ahead and start applying the eyeshadow, and I will get back with you guys.
Alright guys, so now we're going to do a little wing here. And a little wing there. It's called Masterpiece All Day because it is. It's really an easy like 1-2 swipe for beginners and eyeliners. So this color meets dollar store or somewhere really cheap for eyeliner because that's me. I'm going to be using that. Alright, so my mirror is over here. I'm gonna be looking this way while I do that. You do want to start off thin because you can always thicken it, but you don't want to start off too thick because you can't always thin it out. You can, but it will take a lot of work. And it gives you that little fine point, but I'm not going too sharp today. You can always sharpen it up using like concealer. If you know what I mean, use concealer and then just line it up if you want that little sharp edge. But I don't really care for that right now. Doesn't look too bad. Not too bad. So I did just go ahead and pop some color in the eyes real quick. And I figured we'll go with a nice warm lippy because our makeup today is a warm color. So we're gonna go with a nice warm lippy. It's sweet cream from Jordana. You can get this from like your local Walgreens. I really don't need to overline my lips because I have enough, way too much, enough for you and me and the rest of the country. I don't really use any lip liners, I don't know why. I probably try just to see if it makes a difference one day. And that's it for the lippy. And usually I would, back in my days,
I would wear eyeliner, or sometimes nowadays I will put a little white underneath and a little black underneath after the white. So I have a little white in the inner crease and then the dark eyeliner on the outer. But I figured we have enough, we're doing enough right now. So we don't need all that.
Next, we're gonna do the highlighter, my favorite. So usually I would just go with the Nicole Guerrero from Beverly Hills. This is my go-to. But today we're going to use the Kelly Glow, the one I showed you guys earlier.
I know y'all ready, because I'm ready. I know y'all ready, because I'm ready. So you guys, this is one of my hidden talents. I never told anyone because you know I'm a little shy. Holding my phone on my knees while I apply my lashes. Actually, this is my first time doing this, so. It worked with the other lash, so hopefully it works with this one. And I did not use a tweezer to put the other one on. I used my fingers. Okay. It works for me, hopefully it can work for you. And I just woke up one day knowing how to put my lashes on. Like, bloop, bloop. Usually it took me like an hour each. But you guys, I figured no lashes. No, it's like, okay, why not? So.
Now it's time
for the reveal. Hold on, wait. I gotta put this on my camera.
Yeah.
We are ready to be. You're right.
Thank you guys for watching my video. If you enjoyed watching me turn from basic to a baddie, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment down below if you F with it, because I do.